Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages. Welcome to this edition of RV Bandwagon. Alright guys, so here I am in the safari truck and still doing some work to this thing, and today I'm gonna cut a big hole in it. Yeah, I'm gonna cut a big hole in this thing. It's gonna go right in here somewhere over here, because I hooked up the stereo here, but I never quite finished the job because I didn't have the right pieces. I need an access port right here so that this stereo can connect to all of the computer and any other auxiliary type items that I might need over here in this area. So today I've got to cut some of this vinyl out and then get to the fiberglass underneath here and then try to cut a hole in the fiberglass and then put a fixture in here that's made to have wires come out and through. And so we'll see if I can do that, and I'll take you along and see how badly I messed this up. So let's check this out. All right guys, so this thing, when I took it apart, actually had two inner pieces. It has a small one and it has a big one here, and I suppose that's if you're going to hook it up for your power cable coming out of your rig, you can use a small 20 amp or go something bigger to up to a 50 amp. But anyways, I'm just gonna use the big one so I actually have more room for storing the cable ends in here when I close it up. Here's the lid, and it actually gets screwed on there as well. And I'll show you how that goes. Check this out. All right, so I've used the base of this to mark where my hole's gonna be. I've already checked behind here and pretty much clear there. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut this hole in, and we'll see how it goes from there. All right guys, as you can see, I got the unit put in here. However, I have a little problem. I marked it a little bit too far this way and ended up moving it over here. And so I got this little mark I've got to clean up here. But besides that, it came out freaking awesome. So I have all my DVD, USB, Wi-Fi, USB, for the iPad, DVD, 6D, USB. This is for backup camera, or auxiliary, excuse me, backup camera. And one of these I forget. Anyways, and then we have auxiliary audio in. But all these are able to get to really easily now, which is nice. And so one more little thing done to the rig to make it that much better and more usable. Well guys, I've got the rig cleaned up, and I don't know about you guys, but whenever I make a mess in the rig, I'm always really anxious to get the mess cleaned up. And so I've been going through my list. As I showed you on my last vlog, I made a list of things that I needed to do to the rig. It looks like I got four of those projects done, and I was just showing you one of them that I was wrapping up and making a little bit of a mess on, but I got that cleaned up and it looks good. It works good. All my cables are very accessible now. I can get them over to my video system and really be able to get all that whole entertainment slash production area set up. I'm going to be getting a new iMac computer here real soon as part of the setup. And so I'll take you on that journey when it comes along. But really, the rig's coming along. I did the pressure testing on the water for the first time. I tried the pumps out and stuff when I first got this rig, and they worked, but there was a leak, and so I never really used them. And I drained the tanks over the winter time to make sure that nothing froze up. I did all the winterizing and so forth, and then I just refilled the tanks and hooked everything up, and as I showed you on one of my last vlogs, I had a leak on that certain one part under there. Well, I replaced that and fired everything up, fired the hot water heater up, and no leaks. The pressure stayed there overnight in the lines, which is really good. And so it's awesome. The whole water system is now working, which means basically everything in this rig is working 100% at this point, knock on wood. So I was at the recycle store today and I found this for $5 plus a coupon that I had, so I got it for $3, and nice roll of Reflectix to have around the rig. I don't think this could ever be a problem having this stuff around the rig. Anyways, good score today, enough to probably do most of the windows in here. I would like to find a couple new captain's chairs. I'm going to be redoing the wood flooring in here. I should say I'm pulling up the old carpet and putting new wood flooring in here. I'm going to be doing some touch-ups to the dashboard and a few other miscellaneous little things, but for the most part, this rig is going to be pretty much good to go. I thought I'd share that with you while I was out here working on it. Nothing else I can think of right offhand, except for the world's coming to an end. So pay attention, people, and be prepared. Have all your ducks in a row, because you never know what's going to happen. The world's going crazy right now. Yep. All right, guys. This is RV Bandwagon. I'm out, and stay tuned. I've got more fun in the sun coming right here from Eugene, Oregon.